Hey everyone. In this video, I'll be showing you what you can do using the custom email reporting system. There is a lot you can do with the custom email reports, and so I'll only be going through a few examples. To create a custom email report on your Comet server, go into one of your user settings and create a new report. From here, add the email address you want the report to be sent to. Toggle the custom reports to on, and now let's add a new custom report. There are two report types you can choose. You can have your email report be sent immediately if the backup job meets the filter requirements you have set. Alternatively, you can set the report type to a summary table, and this will send a summary report of all the jobs that match the filters you've set on a schedule. Now, I'm going to create an immediate job notification report. I want to make this send an email report when a job is not successful, and so for the type, I will select status, and then not equal, success. That's it, and you can see a preview of it here. Now, if you want to make it even more specific, you can add more rules. I am going to create a new rule and select device ID, equal, device name, and I will also create another rule for protected item ID, equal, one of the protected items on this device. This email report will only send for jobs that are not successful on this device for this protected item. Let's see a preview of the report. As you can see, this is what one of the email reports will look like with these filters set. This time, I will create a summary table report type. I will make this report be sent daily at 9 a.m. For this report, I'm going to make it show all the backup jobs and restore jobs that have a warning or error message. To do this, I will need to create two groups, and each of these groups will need two rules. For the first group, filter the type of jobs that we want reported to show only backup and restore jobs. For the second group, filter the type of status for the jobs we want reported to only show warnings and errors. We only need the report to meet one of these requirements, so I'm going to change the filter to at least one of. And here is the preview. There are many different ways you can configure your custom email reports, and I hope these few examples were helpful to you. Thanks for watching.